Dear friends, welcome back. Today we play with this popular 8x8 LED matrix. As you can see, the matrix is working fine and it displays some simple graphics and some text. The LEDs are very bright and the result is really impressive. The display consists of 64 red LEDs, which are driven by this chip here. This is the MAX7219 in our case, but in your case it will be the MAX7221. You can buy this ready-to-use module pre-soldered on eBay for around 3.5 euros, but if you wish to solder it by yourself, you can buy it for less. You can connect as many as 8 units like this and produce larger displays. That's quite interesting, but we will try this in a future video. Today we will see how to light up only a single unit. The connection with the Arduino board is extremely easy. We only need to connect 5 wires. So, let's begin. The first pin is VCC. VCC goes to Arduino 5 volts. The second pin is ground. Ground goes to Arduino ground. The third pin is D-in. D-in goes to digital pin 12. The fourth pin is CS. CS goes to digital pin 11. And the last pin is clock. Clock goes to digital pin 10. Okay, we are now ready to power on Arduino and see if the matrix is working. Let's do it. Okay, it is working fine. If I remove the LED light a little bit, you can see how bright the matrix really is. Now, let's go to the computer and see the software side of this project. The library that we are going to use in order to drive this LED matrix is the LED control library. You can download it from this link and then you have to unzip it in your Arduino libraries folder. Next, we load the LCD demo matrix program that you can find in a link in the description of the video. Let's take a look at the code. First, we declare the pins that we have connected on Arduino. Then, I have created some byte arrays that contain the data for each character or graphic that we display on the screen. Let's see an example. The first byte is the graphic of a smile. This one is the data for character D. This one is for number 8 and so on. In order to display a byte, all we have to do is to call the print byte custom function and enter as an argument the name of the byte array. For example, if we want to print the smile icon, all we have to do is to call the command print byte and enter the name of the byte array, smile. That's it. Let's now see how to create your own byte arrays with your custom font or graphics. We are going to use a small program I found in which you design your graphic and it quickly produces the data for the byte array. You can find a link for the program in the description of the video. So, let's design a Greek character, the P. Okay, I have created the character and all I have to do is to click the generate button. It creates the byte array data we need. We copy it and we create a new byte array in our code. Okay, I have created this byte and let's call it in our main loop. Okay, the first character that it is going to be displayed when I power on Arduino is the character P that we have just created. Let's see. That's how easy it is to light up this display. Before we go, I am going to show you a small footage from where I live. If you find this video useful, please hit the like button. It really helps. Thanks and see you next week.